Morning everyone, I'm Apeksha, Assistant Professor, Indraprastha Law College. So today we'll be doing the topic, Prime Minister and the Cabinet. It is the third unit and so the whole topic is Prime Minister and the Cabinet, and is the Prime Minister real head? But today in the first lecture we'll be only doing about the Prime Minister, starting from Article 75. What does it say? Article 75 of Indian Constitution mentions that a prime minister is one who is appointed by the president. There is no specific procedure for his election or appointment. Article 74(1) states that there shall be council of minister with the prime minister at the head to aid and advise the president. Who will be aiding and advising the president? A council of minister with the prime minister at the head to aid and advise the president. So thus the Indian Constitution itself recognizes a council of minister. Article 75 specifically says that the prime minister shall be appointed by the president and the other ministers shall be appointed by the president on the advice of prime minister. That is the whole wording of Article 75(1)(1). Moving on to, is the prime minister of India elected or appointed? So as we know that the President of India is constitutional executive head, while the real executive authority of the Union is exercised by the Prime Minister and his Council of Minister. The constitutional executive head is the Prime Minister, the President, whereas the executive authority, the real executive authority, it is exercised by the Prime Minister and its Council of Minister. Now the president of the first point says, the president of India appoints a person as a prime minister who is either the leader of the party which holds a majority of seats in Lok Sabha, or is a person who is able to win the confidence of Lok Sabha by gaining the support of other political parties. All other ministers are appointed by the president on the advice of prime minister. So is the prime minister of India elected or appointed? President of India appoints a person as a prime minister, given under Article 75, as this says. And it is elected by the people of India, right? Now, power and function of prime minister is another point. Before that, I'll also add to that Article 74 of Constitution lays, what does it lay? That there shall be a council of minister with the prime minister at the head to advise the president, who can function, exercise his functions with such advice. So though the president appoint the prime minister, but generally president has no choice in appointment of it, and invites the leader of majority party in the Lok Sabha for this office. He don't have any choice, he just appointed. It has to be clear. Moving on to the power and function of the prime minister, which is again an important part, it can be divided into like legislative power, executive power. So if I start with the first, it says prime minister of India serves the country by following various functions. He performs his function taking responsibility as the leader of the country. Very well said, right? So if I can conclude it in legislative power, the very first point is that it fixes the program of parliament. Then it makes important policy statements in the parliament. A prime minister does that. It is his duty. It is his power and functions which we are talking about. He also advises the president with regard to any summoning, proroguing of the session of the parliament, whether to summon the parliament or not. It is done by, on his advice, he advises the president. He also defends the policies of the government in the parliament. He is a director of foreign policy. He is a leader of Lok Sabha. He recommend dissolution of Lok Sabha. So there are so major power of a prime minister, like portfolio allocation, chairman of the cabinet, Prime Minister is the chairman of the cabinet and presides the meeting of the cabinet. He can impose his decision if there is a crucial opinion difference among member. He can impose his decision. And it will be obligatory for all, for the cabinet to accept it. Otherwise, they can resign. So this is a huge power of the cabinet, the chairman of the cabinet. He's the chairman of the cabinet. Then official representative of the country. Of course, Prime Minister represents the country for high-level international meetings, which we all know. Then there is a link between president and cabinet. What's that? Prime Minister act as the link between president and cabinet. He communicate all the decision of the cabinet to the president. So, what he does is he communicates the decision taken by his cabinet, all the decision taken by the cabinet to the president, which is related to the administration of affair of union and proposals for legislation. He's the head of Nuclear Command Authority, Niti Aayog, Appointment Committee of Cabinet, Department of Atomic Energy, Department of Space, Ministry of Personnel. He's the head of these public grievance and pensions. And he's also a chief advisor to the president. These are some major functions of president. Before that, I'll also add that formation of Council of Minister in appointing, removing, distributing the portfolio to ministers. He has the executive power. This comes under executive power. Then presides the meeting of the cabinet, again executive power. He's the leader of Council of Ministers. This is also executive power. He's the principal channel of communication between the president and Council of Ministers. The sixth point, the link between president and the cabinet. Then he prepares the list for various important appointments, such as governor, judges of Supreme Court, High Court, member of UPSC, Election Commission, ambassador and High Commissioner. These appointments are, however, they are made by the president. Now, Prime Minister, who is eligible to be a Prime Minister? Now, the qualification, the eligibility has also to be discussed. He should be a citizen of India. He must be either, he must be a member of either House of Parliament. And if he is not, he must become within 6 months of his appointment. And of course, the leader of majority party, whoever wins, or one who enjoys the majority support in the Lok Sabha, right? A leader of majority party or one who enjoys his majority support in the Lok Sabha. So all the 3 points written over here. Term, we all know, the Prime Minister whole office during the pleasure of President. Prime Minister stays in office as long as he enjoys the confidence of the Parliament. So that's the term for Prime Minister. But the normal term is 5 years. And it automatically reduces if the House is dissolved before 5 years. If the House gets dissolved before 5 years, then this term, it automatically reduces. So, we are clear with the legislative power and executive power. And now, summing up to the Prime Minister, he's the real head. Alright, I'll be explaining it in another lecture. What does we mean by this and what all it is inclusive of till... In this lecture, we'll be only doing this. Prime Minister, his power, function, eligibility, and we can conclude it, the position of Prime Minister, by right from the days, the first point, right from the days of the first Prime Minister, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Prime Minister is treated at a much higher pedestal. His preeminence rests on his commanding position in cabinet, coupled with the fact that he is the leader of majority party. Now, during the period of Congress rule, the second point, the Prime Minister was usually the president of his party and major campaigner in the elections. All these positions of power when combined in one person make him rank much above an ordinary minister. Right? So, that's what, it's the position of prime minister. The government cannot function without a prime minister. But the absence of minister is easily tolerated and compensated, but not the prime minister. So, thank you. In the next lecture, we'll be doing about cabinet and the real head. I'll be explaining prime minister as the real head. So, thank you.